several questions, if you don't mind.
Sure.
So you were just focusing on 5 out of the 29 genes. What about the other 24 ones?
So the problem is that we don't have enough patient pictures to perform this analysis on all of these GPI3 deficiencies.
Yeah.
And you have to have at least a set of 10 pictures to, as a training set, to be validated by a basic gene. So this is also a call for more facial pictures and more cases with GPI3 deficiencies.
Yeah. And how many patients do you need per gene or per picture?
10 at least,
okay. Yes.
Is there any age dependency? Do you need to have the patients in the same age range because faces change over time at least?
Yes, we see that in several patients that sometimes the facial gestalt worsens over time. Usually our patients are all children within the age between 1 and 10. So it would be good to have a similar age. As soon as we have more pictures, we can then cluster the pictures by age, by gender, by ethnicity, and other co-founding factors. So ethnicity is, I have to admit, is the biggest co-founding factor that leads to high false positive rates.
With regard to hypophosphatasia, is hypophosphatasia really restricted to a particular number of
genes? Yes, the subset of genes that are acting in the middle to last part of the GPIX migration pathway. So sometimes the alpha hypophosphatase stays in the cell and is not being released into the lumen of the blood, so therefore into the blood. In these cases, the patients don't have hypophosphatasia. These are patients that with mutations in the early steps of the anchor pathway, such as PKA and PKN. And patients with mutations in the late steps of the pathway share to have hypophosphatasia. However, hypophosphatasia is not always present in all patients of the same gene mutation. So again, it depends on the mutation.
Yeah.
I think that's a very interesting approach, and I like the approach in a way, but haven't really found out what the relevance is. So if you have a patient with an unknown syndrome, you would always sequence the exome first.
Exactly. So the relevance came up in the time of panel sequencing. Usually when you have an ID patient with epilepsy as the main cardiac features, you would go either for exome. But in this case, if you have a particular panel already provided that covers these PIC genes, then you can basically do a picture analysis, false cytometry, these are fairly cheap, and then decide whether you want to do whole exome sequencing or go for panel sequencing first. This helps the clinician also. If you have, on the other hand, if you have already done exome sequencing, then you can use the facial picture to guide the diagnostics. So you can, you use that tool on one or the other way to either guide you through the diagnostic procedure or help you in prioritizing.